You heard a lot of great things. And I promise you, I'm going to be real brief. But I believe in honest, law-abiding citizens. If they choose to arm themselves and haven't done anything wrong, I believe in that is our basic right. And I believe with the sergeant here that training is great. Let me introduce some folks I brought with me. Deputy Chief Danny Hallmark, in charge of my training academy. Deputy Philip Landon, my warrant detail, Crime Stoppers, also a trainer at the academy. Captain Felicia Rucker, in charge of my, she's done everything and been honored by the NAACP as the Woman of the Year. But she runs everything in Bessemer. These are the type of folks that I agree with the training. You know what? If you're going to carry, you don't have to be trained. But the one thing about police officers and the why a police officer is going to carry something off duty and why that police officer or security guard is valuable to your congregation is they've probably been trained and feel good. Not only is a police officer mandated to carry it and deputies off duty, but we're trained to do it. If you're an honest, law-abiding citizen, you can purchase a gun. You can, if you have a $7.50 permit, you can take it with you that day. But please, just because you're legally entitled to carry it, you also are carrying deadly force. So between the NRA and Bama Carry and VPD and my great bunch of firearms instructors, best in the state at our training academy, we'll do it free. Come and let us train you. I tell you, I just want people out there that are hearing this for the first time to feel like myself and my deputies and the sergeant. When we go out at night, we take a gun. I'm like Danny. I'm not scared to be without a gun, but I have a responsibility to defend a citizen and take action. And I've had to do that. And I've also had the incredible privilege, and I can't remember his name, but I was making an arrest at Winn-Dixie, struggling with a guy by myself who really didn't recognize me as sheriff, imagine that. And I'm rolling at the Winn-Dixie in the floor. Thank God for an off-duty Birmingham policeman that identified himself and was armed, and together we arrested. Now, to get to the, we made the arrest. Go online, jeffcosheriff.net. You don't have to have a firearm to fill out a pistol license. Send it in. If you have a pistol license, when you buy a gun, you can take it with you. If you don't have that pistol license, you have to wait. In Alabama, you can be 18 years of age, fill it out, no arrest, good citizen, and you can carry it concealed. Now, the law is going to say this. I know you're interested. You do not have to have a pistol license to have that gun or firearm at your home, your property, or your place of business, or if you're open carrying in a business that doesn't prohibit. The church is the property owner. If you're posted, no firearms allowed, no firearms allowed. You're the property owner. But I would suggest this, and it's been mentioned, everybody doesn't come to church with the best intentions. We've all seen the mentally ill and people that do things that they're acting out and they don't know how they're acting that causes alarm and is hurtful conduct and is threatening conduct. Those people should not have pistol lights. They shouldn't be. But those are the type of people, also the nefarious people, has been said, the offering, the canning of the money, the iPhones left in the car. I haven't heard one pastor, but I would say, let's take our iPhones and phones in the church and let's practice. If there's an event, let's practice. But when we're run, when we found a safe place, let's find out who it is. Let's don't assume our neighbor's calling. Dial 911. Who is it? What type guns? How many of it? That's instant information that can help out. I just have one thing I want, and I'm going to wrap it up. I would suggest that we have a moral fiduciary duty as churches to protect each other and not be sheep, and we have to fight back. I think I have an obligation that if something goes down here, I, as just a Christian, to do what I can to stop Representative Gavan from being hurt, to run and do something and not acknowledge that this is a program is just not right. I like the scripture, Matthew 10, before I send you out as sheep, as in the midst of wolves. Therefore, be as wise as serpents, as harmless as a dove. I believe that with my heart. My prayer for you is for you to feel as safe as me and my deputies and any off-duty Birmingham policeman as we worship in church, because I promise you, I've been trained, I carry, and I'm going to be helpful. Now, what we're going to do, and I wrap it up, I've given some handouts. My guys, I don't care if you're in the city of Birmingham, city of Bus, I don't care where you are, we will sit down with you and we will help you form a security plan, an assessment. And it can be as complex as a largest church in Birmingham, and it can be as small as 10 folks worshiping, but as an active community. Because when you throw a shingle out and you throw something out, people are going to come, and we just got to be prepared to act. So go to the Jeffco Sheriff website. Consider filling out a pistol license. I'll be happy. I'll be around to the end, and I'll be happy to answer any questions about concealed carry, open carry. You got to carry it in a car. You got to have a permit right now. You don't have to have it in your home or business. And if I'm going to carry it concealed in my pocket and go to the church, and I'm a layman, I need that. You have to have a permit to carry concealed. $7.50 in this county. I'll be around. Thank you. God bless you. It's great to see the community out talking about this. Thank you.
Thank you.